Very good morning, my dear students. Today you are going to learn about a portable dialyzer monitoring and functional parameters. So today you are going to learn a portable dialyzer monitoring and functional parameters. So here what we can see means, so you are seeing here is a hemodialyzer. Hemodialyzer, what you are seeing here is a that is a unclean blood is taken from a artery, which is given to the paralytic pump, blood pump, that will pump this unclean blood to the dialyzer. Dialyzer, it is having a exchange dialyzer chamber. In the dialyzer chamber, it is having a semi permeable membrane and. Dialysate have been added with the dialysate chamber, and also the water is distilled water is also added with the dialysate chamber. So with the help of osmosis method, the blood is have been purified. That is, after purified blood, again it is given to the vein. That is, we are calling that as a hemodialysis process. This one we know that is called as a hemodialysis process. So here what is the we have discussed hemodialysis process means, it's a, so whenever the renal failure is happened, so that is what is a renal failure means. It is describes a situation when a kidney is failed to work. This may be a permanent or a temporary failure. So when the kidneys fails, the waste being accumulated in our blood, that is called as a uremia. So accumulating blood is called a uremia, waste or, and as a hemostasis is upset within our body, and other organs can also being shut down, and due to this one, the function of heart, liver, it will also lower its functioning. So the end of the result, the renal failure is usually a death unless the blood is filtered by some other means. So the deal intervention is a replaced the failed kidney with the donor kidney, that is called STSC. That is okay. And intervention, that means these kind of problem can be rectified only by the providing the donor kidney. Okay. So here, while a person waits to a donor kidney, they usually have to undergo a dialysis, a method where the blood is filtered and cleaned on a regular basis using the dialyzer machines. This dialyzer machines, which provides about what is the function of dialysis machines. And in this case, the main stage is that the blood is passed through during the dialysis process, which includes the blood is enters the machine from the body, that is under the pressure from a radial artery. Then it is sent to the pump you are seeing in the diagram, that is called as a roller pump or paralytic pump, which controls the pressure and the flow rate. So there is a anticoagulant is added to prevent the clotting. The blood then passes through the dialysis membrane, that is equivalent to the kidney nephrons. Here the dialysis membrane we are making equal to kidney nephron. Here the bubble which have been happened, that bubble have been trapped, then removes any gas bubbles from the blood, which is filtered, then returned to the patient radial vein. So this is one you are observed it. So this hemodialysis machine you are going to see here. This is the hemodialysis machine. They are operating in all the dialysis center. So this is the biggest unit. So in this lecture, you are going to learn about the portable dialyzer machine and its functional parameters. That you are going to learn. So here, portable dialyzer is more convenient, and it can be taken to any places where the patient is not able to move towards the hospital. For them, it has been decided. It is a very easiest method to dialyze the blood in a patient's womb. So here, what this means here, you are seeing here, that is figure A. It shows about the clinical dialysis machine, and figure B shows the portable dialysis machines. So this is the model you are seeing it. So there is a two difference here. This one is a n number of patient can be go for a dialysis. This can be used. This one portable, one person can take the dialysis. So this is the difference between these two things. And so here hemodialysis, when you consider, means here that the principle of hemodialysis is same as the method of dialysis in our kidney. It involves diffusion of solute across a semi-permeable membrane, and hemodialysis utilizes counter current flow method, where the dialysate is flowing in opposite direction to the blood flow in the external corporeal circuit. That is, in the external corporeal circuit, this dialysate, it will flow in opposite to the blood flow. So here the counter current flows maintains the concentration gradient across the membrane at a maximum, and which increase the efficiency of dialysis. Here the fluid is a removal, that is called ultrafiltration, which is achieved by the alternating hydrostatic pressure of the dialysate compartment, causing the free water and some dissolvent solute to move across the membrane along with the created pressure gradient. So the dialysis solution that is used to be sterilized solution of mineral ions or accompany with the paracoporia. So here the urea and other waste product, potassium and phosphate, diffuses into dialysis solution. So but the, by that way we can remove these one. So however, the concentration of sodium and chloride are similar to those of a normal plasma to prevent the loss. Sodium bicarbonate is added in a higher concentration that plasma to correct blood acidity. A small amount of glucose is also commonly used here. So now the same circuit diagram of these portable dialyzer you are going to see in this figure. Here what you are seeing is that is called the entire circuit diagram of a portable dialyzer machines. So entirely it is having electronic equipments and a pump that have been controlled by the embedded system that you are seeing here. So this is the portable machine, that same circuit, inside the circuit have been given here. So this one, it shows the block diagram of portable dialysis machine. So this has been designed by the Texas Instrument in India. They have designed it. So India, the nowadays they are developing a lot of a medical instrument in order to provide the facility to the all hospitals. And first we will discuss we are going to discuss now. We'll see one by one, and so other what are the things we are going to learn, means first we'll see about the dialysate circuit. So here the dialysate circuit is a clinical setting, and dialysate is usually pre-mixed to the proper concentration for the direct use in home units to keep container size down. Concentrated forms of dialysate are often used and distilled with the sterilized water in the machine. Thus, the home unit must include the water heater, valve, pump and a variety of sensor to perform these extra steps. The lower power consumption in the home units and the dialysate preparation process is often performed at a time which is separately from a dialysis. So you are seeing this is a home unit dialyser or a portable dialyser. So the both types of machines which include the capability to add a bicarbonate buffer solution to the dialysate. Now next you are going to learn the disinfection circuit. That is also one of the part in a portable dialyser. So here after the dialysis process get over, that is a dialysis procedure, the machine must be cleaned and sterilized. These provisions are made in a plumbing to close to the circuit into the loop and run a saline and other sterilized water through the system to flush away all the impurities. Next, you are going to learn about the special requirement of this home unit or a portable dialyser. In this case, for a general convenience, the home system, that is called a portable dialysis, are smaller and sometimes very portable. Since they require the additional function of dialysate preparation, the need for a small compact design is increased over the clinical machines. The disinfection cycle at the end of therapy is also a power hungry process to accomplish the heating required in a reasonable amount of time. Batteries or ultra capacitors are included to provide the short term high power capability to supplement the line power as needed. When the line power usage drops below the 15 amp limit, the batteries or ultra capacitor are recharged. That is the main function of this special requirement. Now we'll go for one by one. Another one we are going for a learning about portable dialyser monitoring. So you are going to learn the portable dialyser monitoring. So what all things you are going to learn here is a first one is a display background. Second one is a touch screen, a keyboard. Third one is a data interface. So these things you are going to learn from the portable dialysis monitoring. First we'll discuss about portable dialysis monitoring. In this case, we'll learn about what is the function of a display and a backlight. What is the backlight functioning, we'll discuss. And here the clinical dialysis machines commonly have a relatively large displays in the clinical purpose, approximately size of a computer size where you are seeing in a hospital. Here in a home unit, that is a portable dialyser, have much smaller display, very very smaller display. And modern machines normally employ a graphical user interface, that is called a GUI for ease of use. They use a liquid crystal display, that is called LCDs, instead of cathode ray tube, that is CRT monitoring, to reduce the weight and power consumption. Maximum supplies LDVS, that is a sterilizer and a de-sterilizer, uniquely suited for LCD panels. This solution covers a wide range of bit width, that is from 1 to 27 bit width, and speed up to 2.5 gigabytes. So they can translate between the different logic levels, example from LVC CMOS to LVDS. That is to measure the compatibility between the processor, video interface and the display module. You have already seen in these diagram as well as a diagram number 3. Now we are going to learn about the touch screen and keyboard in a portable dialyzer. Okay, what is the function of touch screen and keyboard in a portable dialyzer? Here the Maximum offers a variety of keyboard scanners, including a device that allows multiple simultaneous key pressures. In many applications, keyboards are being displayed by the touch screen, which can improve the user experience when paired with the intuitive GUI, that is it has been provided in a touch screen and keyboards. So next we are going to discuss about data interface. Data interfaces, that means a running record of a dialysis process for which a patient session is kept electronically or made available in a number of ways. Dialysis machine can includes USB port, Ethernet and a variety of serial port, that is RS-232, RS-485, RS-422 are available, and which is interfaces to the legacy hospital information system. And also here you can see the wireless interfaces, that is called Wi-Fi. It also also can be included in this device for direct the connection to the hospital wireless network. So they can monitor, and it has been given directly to the hospital session. So that is the main advantage in a portable dialyzer machine. Now we'll see the functional parameters. So what is the functional parameters of portable dialyzer? We'll see one by one. So what are the things you are going to learn it, we'll see that one. So you are here the functional parameters having a pump, another one is valves, another one is processing, another one is fall safe circuitry, that means any failure is happened, it is provide the fail safe circuitry, that is the device is available. Another power supply also monitoring is there. So here there is a what is a safety regulation about the functional parameters. These are all we are going to discuss now. So and one more things we are going to discuss the advantages of this one. This is which is provides a entire operation. Okay, first we'll discuss about the functional parameters. First one is called pump. Pumps here, what is that they are using means peristaltic pumps they are using, and commonly that is only they are using here for drive. Driving the various higher volume fluid in the machine, blood, dialysate, water and solid. That means the peristaltic pumps are commonly used for driving the various higher volume fluid in the machine, blood, dialysate, water and saline. So this type of pump is very convenient because it does not touch the fluid directly. Instead, a section of flexible tubing runs through the pump mechanism where it is compressed by the roller to push the fluid forward. These pumps are required a significant amount of power and driven by either DC or AC motor with a variable speed control. And here the electronic means must be provided to ensure that motor is turning at the desired rate. The maximum that has a off effect sensor that gives a fully independent signal picked up from the actual shaft rotation, which can be used for redundancy. And one more thing, if the motor is already have a off effect sensor built in, and that is okay. And for lower volume fluid such as heparin, syringe pump mechanism is commonly used to driven by the smaller stepper motor or DC motor, which provides a precision measurement of a proper mechanism, and it provides a lot of advantages. Next one, we are going to learn about the valve. So what is the valve here, function of here? Here we know that several valves with the electronic actuation are needed in a machine to allow the variable mixing ratios. Various implementation are possible, from a simple opened or closed valves driven by the solenoid to precision variable position valve driven by the stepper motors or other means. Here the between the patient sensations, that is any reused component must be sterilized. And one approach is to heat the water or solvent to high sterilizing temperature and then run it through the machine, both through the extracorporeal circuits and through the dialysis circuits. Here, whatever the cleaning mode is used, the machine may require additional driving and monitoring for proper operations. Next, what is the processing unit? Here, because of a large number of output signal to be monitored and the large number of pumps and other mechanism to be controlled, many of these functions are performed with the dedicated microcontrollers for a portion of the system, which controlling overall system that will be maintained by the processor that is providing the capable of running a full operating system using GUI, that is a graphical interface unit. So another which provides the communication between the controller and which require that is its need in order to this communication, which is required to send the data, commands and alerts. So these are all parameter you have seen here. Next we will see about the safety fail safe circuitry. So fail safe circuitry is very important in all the machines. Why? Means the IC with the self test and fault reporting capabilities are very useful for maintaining the patient's safety under a single fault condition here. So additional monitoring circuitry is commonly used to monitor the power supply voltages, while watchdog circuits are used to ensure the microprocessor operation remains within the bounds. Okay, so another, the both audible and visible alarms are provided to alert user when a warning is needed or a fault condition is occurred. So that is very important. This is included in a fail safe circuitry. Next one we'll see about the power supply. Here that is very important. So due to a long duration of a dialysis process, all dialysis equipment is a AC line powered here. So standard AC to DC converter meeting medical safety standards are employed in these equipments. Due to the variety of components requiring power, a variety of voltage rails are needed at a different power levels. A power systems with the multiple output switching regulator is needed with a significant amount of what we can say means line regulations, that is called line regulation, at the load for a noise sensitive precision circuit. Next we will see about the safety regulation. So here the safety regulation is very important for all the devices, which here also which is included. So safety regulation is required for a power supply, self monitoring for voltage and temperature, and also current flow. So over voltage and under voltage detector are commonly used for safety regulation. Due to the high power levels, the active cooling is required using the fan and temperature sensor in a variety of location they are using. These portable dialyzer machines, which includes the water sterilization capabilities, which can require more power than is available from a standard wall outlet, that is 15 amp. Therefore, the power must be capable of limiting the current drawn from the AC line and adding in the parallel power from a battery, that is the ultra capacitor. So as I discussed, these are all in above, that is portable dialyzer the machines, which needs to include the batteries also, that is called the battery name is called ultra capacitor, which to supplement the power supplies output power when heating water for sterilization. These are all they are using. These must be charged whenever possible, and a fuel gauge to indicate the when enough capacity is available to proceed with the water sterilization process. Next we'll see discuss about the advantages. So what are the advantages of these portable dialyzer machine? First one, which includes capability to add a bicarbonate buffer solution. Second one is the patient with a complete loss of kidney function would needed to visit the clinic at least 3 times per week and spend about 4 hours connected to the machine. So with the help of these portable machine, the patient have more flexible in scheduling their dialysis, and they can dialyze for long periods and more frequently in their home itself. Third advantage is a low power design. It is a low power. Fourth advantage is it is a wireless interface, that is such is called a Wi-Fi connection is available, which direct connection to the hospital to the wireless network. So fifth advantage, the data card slots are available on some designs. This allows the patient to carry an ID card with respect to medical information stored on it, enable to automatic setup of many of the machines parameters. So this is highly advantage about this. Okay, now we'll discuss what is the summary of this portable dialysis machine. So the portable dialysis machine is better when compared to other dialyzer because it is having the above advantages. So this dialyzer has a very good sensitivity. The here the frequency range of operation is about 8 MHz. The temperature operating range is about minus 40 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. And here the sensor and prices of instrument is affordable. And here the Wi-Fi connectivity is available, which is implanted in this device. So this is the main advantages of a portable dialysis machines. Thanks for listening this class. So I hope that you understand about the portable dialysis machine.